All right, what I'm about to show you is a problem that I solved. You know, something like it. A problem that I solved. You know, making progress in physics. Let's go. Talking calculations. All right, so we have an airplane. You know, a small airplane, and we're going to design a runway for this airplane. Got a runway, and it's like about 150 meters, and we're not sure if the runway is long enough for this airplane. Yeah, so we're not sure if this runway is long enough for this airplane. And because the airplane, here's some knowns about the airplane, or here's some knowns about the physics problem in general. Fucking x of naught equals zero. We're starting at zero position, like starting at the end of the runway, and we're starting at with the velocity of zero. And the runway goes 150 meters. And the acceleration of this airplane is going at 2 meters per second squared. And we need to find the velocity this airplane can go at 150 during this, it needs to go at. Needs to go at 270.8 meters per second. And unknown, we're trying to find the velocity. Right. And here's some equations we could use. You put this on the marker. How did this marker draw out? I swear. Fuck. Now, what really struck me on this problem was the facts of moving around the equations to get what you want. I think that's the part I really struggle with the most. Besides that, I think I could build up the practice of actually like understanding the problem and getting what they're asking for. Because it's all a bunch of plug and chug, but still gotta realize what you're plugging and chugging. Make sure you're going in the right place and using the right equation. Alright, so we know this, port 150 meters will not cut it. In order to find a velocity, we could use this equation. I guess it's what it is right here. V squared equals V naught squared plus 2, wait. V Yeah, plus 2a parentheses multiply by the x minus x naught. So the velocity is equal to the starting velocity plus the acceleration multiplied by the distance of the, you know, the distance of the runway is basically what they're saying. And I can say fuck that, I'm gonna go off the books. We need this, the solving for and v0 equals 0, so we're starting from 0 velocity, 2 times the acceleration, which is 2 meters per second squared, times the runway distance, length. So we can go ahead and say that 4 meters per second squared multiplied by 150 meters equals 600 meters squared second squared. In order to get that, we have to put that in, we have to square root that, pretty much. We have to try and put it. Square root it. And we get it. And we got 24.5 meters per second. And that is not what we need. So the airplane isn't fast enough with this particular runway. Not fast enough. It will not make it. So in order to find what we need, I'm gonna let you go, like, give me time to copy that down. In order to find what we need, we can still use this equation, but we could put the needed velocity in, and we can find the distance for the runway instead of using their runway, which is 150 meters. We can use the minimum runway requirement. We can find that using this equation here. But it is not in the form that we need it in, so we could say square minus v, no, v naught. V naught squared, v way. And we're looking for the length. So we're trying to find this, get that to the dot. Da 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 da. Alright, so this is the equation that we need in order to find the length of the runway. So let's plug in our knowns or unknowns. Well, our knowns, you know, most likely. Alright. B-Dot squared is also 0. And we get the length of the runway, which is equal to 193.21 meters. So roughly 200 meters. So in order for an airplane to gather the speed that it needs to take off, we need a runway of exactly 193.21 meters, or we could just say it needs 200 meters of runway length. Just, you know, just to edge off those numbers, round off a bit, we say it needs 200 meters of runway length. But, and that is one of the problems I figured out using physics. Physics has, you know, many important aspects of life. It solves problems. It gives you the tools to solve those problems. And that's how we get our grandkids to Mars.